A fully autonomous car is one that can drive itself without you paying attention to traffic.
While many car makers are currently developing and testing autonomous cars, they're not really ready for showrooms.
Semi-autonomous cars, however, are in showrooms and on the road today.
Although semi-autonomous cars can drive themselves for short distances, like on the freeway, they require the driver to pay full attention and retake control at any moment. That's because, unlike fully autonomous cars, they don't have redundant safety backup systems. In a semi-autonomous car, the driver is the safety backup.
No matter if a car is semi or fully autonomous, it navigates the road with the same tech systems. These include digital cameras, lasers, and radar sensors. Semi-autonomous cars have these mounted in the front of the car. Most fully autonomous cars, however, will have sensors embedded all around the car, giving it a 360-degree view of the traffic and road around it.
An autonomous car takes information gathered by exterior sensors and basically creates a video game in reverse.
Oh, I like Mario Kart, duh.
No. Let me explain what I mean. Essentially, a video game takes code and turns it into a digital image. Autonomous cars do that in reverse. They take a visual image and convert it into a code that its systems can interpret. That's how the steering, braking, and throttle are able to be controlled just like a human driver. The onboard computers are seeing like we do, but with a much broader view. With this precise 360-degree view, an autonomous car can see more and react more quickly than a human driver ever could.
Looking beyond the immediate view around the car, an autonomous car knows where it's going based upon GPS navigation. Although self-driving cars could easily rely on current GPS, automakers like Toyota and Tesla are working on developing high-definition GPS maps.
These high-def GPS maps will do more than just broadly tell the self-driving car where the road is, but instead give a more detailed view of the road ahead. This way, the car will know about a blind corner even before it can see it with its own sensors.
Car makers are also working to improve a self-driving car's ability to know about street and traffic conditions long before it ever reaches the road.
Toyota will soon be transmitting images captured from its cars that have forward and rear-facing cameras into a cloud computer system. There, Toyota will build a real-time street view map of global freeways, which, in turn, will be fed back to its cars.
Lastly, car companies are working on a Wi-Fi-based vehicle communication technology called vehicle-to-vehicle, or V2V. V2V will allow self-driving cars to monitor one another with their exterior sensors, but also communicate with one another. Moreover, cars can warn one another about ice on the road or other roadway hazards. Again, that way your car will know the road ahead before it starts every journey.
Currently, only one car on the road today has V2V, and that's the 2017 Mercedes-Benz E-Class. However, it's expected many more cars will implement the technology as semi and full autonomy becomes more common.
But the question on everyone's mind is, when are these fully autonomous cars going to start solving mysteries like Kit from Knight Rider?
So long as you have no follow-up questions, very soon.
Hey, thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video, subscribe to this channel for more, and Nick, thanks for coming out. It's been fun, man.
From the bottom of my heart, it was pretty good to be here.
Check out Nick's coverage of the New York Auto Show this week. It's gonna be really cool. What is everyone looking forward to this year?
Sitting down.